This tutorial shows you how to calculate the minimum required sample size for the one-sample Wilcoxon signed rank test with G-Power. When we start G-Power, we get this overview by default. We now need to select the one-sample Wilcoxon signed rank test first. This can either be done via test family and statistical test, or via tests, means, one group, non-parametric. Now you have to select the type of power analysis. Since you have to calculate the minimum required sample size in advance, you have to select a priori. The first input parameter needed is whether you are testing one-sided or two-sided. Two-sided or two-tailed means you cannot tell in advance whether your observed median might be above or below the population or a hypothesized mean. If you do, however, assume that, select one-tailed. The second input parameter is the assumed parent distribution. Min ARE, or asymptotic relative efficiency, is the most conservative one and is a good default assumption, in case you don't know it. The third input parameter is the effect size Cohen's D. The G-Power manual states that the conventions by Cohen that are applicable for the t-test should be used for the one-sample Wilcoxon test as well. They are 0.2, 0.5 and 0.8 for small, medium and large effect sizes. If you have research field-specific thresholds, use those instead. However, if you have a preliminary study or comparative study where an effect size exists, you should rather use that. Transformations in advance might be necessary though. The fourth input parameter is the alpha error probability, which is the probability of committing a type 1 error. In short, this is the probability of wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis. 5% is the typical convention, 1% is a bit more restrictive, and a value above 5% should be avoided. The fifth and final input parameter is power. Power equals 1 minus the beta error probability. Beta error is the type 2 error. In short, this means falsely retaining the null hypothesis. 95% power is typical, meaning you have a maximum of 5% type 2 error probability. In some research fields, 0.8 is used here. This means you automatically accept a type 2 error of up to 20%. If you have power lower than 95%, this calls for a reasonable justification. Finally, hit calculate to see the minimum number of observations needed to detect the presumed statistical effect with the predefined type 1 error probability and power. As a rule of thumb, a smaller effect size and a larger power require more observations than the other way around.